Today on the Bulldog Tour Show, we're going to go to the Old City Jail in downtown Charleston and hear the story of its most famous ghost.
And it's a she, the most famous ghost who haunts the Old City Jail. Her name is Lavinia Fisher, America's first female serial killer. I'm standing in front of the Old City Jail on Magazine Street in downtown Charleston. This is regarded as the most haunted building in the entire state of South Carolina. And they used to take women. They did not separate women in separate jails until 1911. So if women committed violent crimes, they wound up in here with the men. The most famous ghost who haunts the Old City Jail, her name is Lavinia Fisher. She was raised on a farm outside of town. And at some point in her early life, married a man named John Fisher, and they turned to a life of crime. They wound up running a vicious gang of highway robbers north of Charleston back in the early 1810s. They owned a hotel, and the legend has it that they would lure the men into the hotel who were on their way into the city to trade, often frontiersmen, and they would lure them in. Lavinia would feed them. She would give them a cup of oleander tea. Once they were poisoned, she'd take them to a room and they would never walk out. John and Lavinia would drop them down in a pit by pulling a lever in the hotel late at night that would cause their bed to collapse into the pit where they would be waiting with knives. It was quick and it was efficient. They were able to bury the bodies, sell the furs, anything else they had with them that they had brought with them from the frontier. They got away with it for a while, but eventually justice caught up with them and they wound up spending about 6 months here in the city jail in the room we're standing in now. Lavinia and her husband John were brought here, thrown in a cage. The entire city of Charleston wanted to see both of them swing from a rope. But there was an old law on the books that had been there forever, which said that this state did not hang married women. Everyone knew about it. Everyone was curious to see what the judge was going to do. Well, after hearing the evidence, he sentenced both of them to hang publicly. Lavinia had been counting on that law to save her life, so she stood up in court and argued with the judge, "Your Honor, you can't hang me. Your Honor, I'm a married woman. I know my laws, my rights in this state. You can't touch me." And the judge supposedly looked over the bench very calmly and said, "Mrs. Fisher, don't you think I've thought this through? All I have to do is make sure we hang your husband first. Then you're a widow, and I can do as I please."